because usually the doctors will always try to help those patients which have the worst conditions. So today, we are, you can say, we can proudly say that, that the problem of the lack of bone is solved for more than 99% of the patients. So almost everybody can be treated, and now it's only a matter of time until this technology will find its way into the dental offices around the world. So are there questions to this?
How many cases you done about these implantations?
This is a very difficult question. I think several thousands of cases in the last 15 years.
In
Europe, in my office in Switzerland, and in Europe, many cities where I help doctors to learn the technique. So it usually works like this, that when I'm invited into a clinic, and then I come to this clinic quite often until everything runs smoothly, until the dentist technicians know how to do it, until the surgeons know how to do it. So sooner or later I can then fade out, and then I look for another clinic or another university to implement this.
Okay, then which technology used for the 3 days dental implantation? Normally, it will take 1.5 months
or
this time, right?
So we use basal implants, and the technology is very similar to the treatment of fractures in orthopedic surgery. So when you have, let's say, a fracture of the arm, you can get plates, and these plates are screwed in, and the surgical technology and the design of the implants is very similar to what is done in these. Cases. You know, so far, dental implantology is not or has not used the knowledge which is available in traumatology and in orthopedic surgery. Dental implantology has developed a little bit independently. Therefore, the successes were not so big. There was not a lot of exchange. Exchange of knowledge and dental implantology, the old type of dental implantology, I think it was off track. I think there was no real science behind it, and I think this problem is solved.
For this treatment, any dye plant for the patient?
Any dye plant for the patient?
Any dye plant
have the patient to take some particular diet?
After the implant, obviously I would not. Kind of go to the surface and do this kind of experiment, but besides this, I have to be a little bit careful.
In 3 months' time, the implant becomes very firmly anchored in the bone. After that, patient can do a little bit of tricks. They can eat more harder food, and they can eat the normal diet which everyone does.
Many years ago, we were telling the patient to avoid hard food. We are not giving these recommendations. We are just telling them all the
time. So, whatever life is implanted in
See, basically, I have undertaken training under Dr. Stephen himself. I have been to Europe twice and imbibed those techniques from him. And since 6 years, I have been practicing in Hyderabad.